Today I'm going to be demonstrating how to use a vernier micrometer by measuring a valve shim from a high-performance motorcycle engine. The valve shims are a critical component to the engine and have to be exact. That little piece of metal goes on top of the valve and takes up the space between the valve and the camshafts. And if it's not exact, then things like the valves can end up hitting the pistons on the top side and causing problems. When these parts are turning at over 14,000 RPM, you can see why it's critical to have them so precise. Whether it's on a piece of paper or an Excel file like I've done, you want to set it up so that you have the measurements for your two sleeve measurements, one thimble measurement, and one vernier measurement. And you can see I've noted them as the sleeve being a 100 thousandths measurement, then in increments of 25 thousandths measurements, then the 1 thousandth, then the 1 10,000th. The first thing to do is make sure that your micrometer is zeroed out. So if we move it all the way in by rotating the thimble here, and then finish by rotating in the ratchet, and what we want to see is that the zero line on the thimble lines up with the zero line across from it on the vernier. Perfect. Okay. So now we rotate it back. We give it a little bit of space to insert our valve shim. Okay. Now that the valve shim is in place, I'm going to turn it pretty close, and when there's almost no play left, I'm going to rotate the ratchet, and that's going to be the final spot. Look at the vertical lines on the sleeve down there, and you can see it goes zero, and then little lines, and then the one. So what that one represents, and the one is the last whole number you see before the thimble starts, so that one represents 100 thousandths. So I'm going to go put 100 thousandths on my spreadsheet for that line. Now you see on the sleeve, there's that one little line after the one, and that represents another 25 thousandths. So I'm going to go put another 25 thousandths into my spreadsheet. And now we want to look at the thimble, which is this part, right? And the last number before the zero line, you can see is that one, right? And it's right below the zero line. So one is the number we're taking away from there. And that one represents another thousandth, okay? So we're gonna enter 0.001 into the spreadsheet. The last measurement is the actual vernier. And what you're looking for, see how the zero line is a little higher than the one on the right? And then the one is just a little higher than the two on the right. And the two is getting pretty close, the vernier, as far as lining up with the line. And then the three is a little bit lower. So what you want to do is pick the one that it's most matched to, and if you look across there, it looks like the two on the vernier, which is on the left, like that two is the one that lines up closest with a line on the thimble. So that two is another 2 10,000ths. So we're going to enter 0.0002 into the spreadsheet. Now you can see in this spreadsheet, I already had the math pre-populated so that it just sums up those values, and then you get a number of 0.1262 inches. Now I can take that number, basically enter it in over here, enter, and then it calculates out that it's about 3.2 millimeters for me. I'll repeat this on down the line for the 16 shims. And that's how you use a vernier micrometer to measure a valve shim. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to learn more about how to enjoy amazing machines like this.